0133 2 Derby 616161. David Moore, BBC Radio Derby Travel.
The Breakfast Show with E.
That is very, very slippy. No stopping that. That's just fucking solid ice, that is. Make a space.
And that montage of just some of our many hits, introduced by guest Paloma Faith. Yay! How are you?
Really good.
And listen, congratulations, you did it. Number one album.
I can't believe it. It's taken me ages.
What was sweet was that you could tell it really, you wanted it. It wasn't, you weren't playing it cool.
No,
you were going, I really want to be number one.
Never been cool. Yeah, no, it was exciting. When it felt like it might be possible, then I started sending out all the desperate tweets saying, if you're thinking about buying it, but
right,
not sure, or you've still got
start going low range down this hill.
Please, can you do it this week?
And is it one of those scary things where you're number one midweek, but you're still waiting to see, presumably.
I mean, I'd like to just, give some credit to number two, because I've always said, because I've always been kind of second best most of my life, I always think not enough credit is given to number two. And it's just like they wouldn't put it on a poster like the number two album. And it's really it's quite high. They always put the top 10 album, and they've sort of like negated that 8 spaces that you've beaten. So I just think, like, if you put it in context, like the second best in the world. I mean, I know the charts aren't, but the second best in Britain is pretty good.
Yes.
So I would have been happy with that. But, number one's just that little, in my case, 800 copies more exciting.
Every vote counts. Why do you think this was the album? Is it just because you've built up a fan base over the years? Every album you've kind of, like a Rolling Stone, you've gathered fans as you went.
I think so, but also I think that there's a thin line between love and hate, and I think that I'm naturally polarizing. So I think, like, some people are like, oh, I hate her, everything she does, oh my god, I love her. There's never like, oh, I'm starting to come round. And I feel like this sort of illustrates that about me. I've always been like that. I mean, I'd much rather sort of go into a room and the room full of people a reaction than just be like, oh, who do you meet? Who are you talking about? No, I can't remember her. I'd rather they were like, she is appalling.
Do you have a thick skin? Do you have thick skin?
Probably.
What I mean is that, that whole kind of social media thing, which I understand you have to do because it's part of your job now. But do you have to kind of brace yourself before you open the Twittersphere?
Yes, I do. And obviously, I'm a normal human being. Like, for every 50 positive ones, I'll always focus on the one bad one. Be like, this person said, and then it's like the whole night, and everyone's like, we're bored of your conversation. Can we just talk about other things?
does any bit of you want to just step away from that side of the business and
people do, and I admire those people. And I feel like since having my child, I have to some degree, like I don't really